What's up YouTube? You already know, it's Dammy and I'm back with another video. So today's video is gonna be like a little vlog. I already posted a video the other day. It's like a follow-up. Got my nails done yesterday. Giving very much mother. Like this is like that color that mothers be getting. But it matches my cap and gown. I'm actually about to head out. I have to walk to my school and pick up my graduation tickets. There was a complication. I have to go over there. But I have to walk like 30 minutes. Ooh. It's on the same street, but it's so long, you know? So I'm gonna get on the phone with my best friend. Y'all see the glow? Nothing crazy with the outfit. I just have this Heir to the Throne Nike shirt. I got on these basketball shorts. It's Nikes. And then I have on my little fanny pack.
And it was at this moment that he knew.
I'm wearing these Old Navy branded Birkenstocks, which are comfortable. I don't really care about name brand stuff. We're gonna head out. I'm probably gonna pick up some food on the way because there's a few stores and there's places right across the street from my school where I can get stuff to eat. I might not vlog too much of the walk because I'm gonna be on the phone with my best friend. Don't mind my face. I'm like breaking out. Who cares though? Okay, good morning y'all. It's the next day and I ended up not vlogging any part of that walk because I was just so stressed out trying to get through that walk. So I'm just gonna be giving y'all a haul of what I got from the beauty supply store and what I got from the stores because I got some stuff for my graduation. So I'm gonna do that and then I'm gonna show y'all me prepping my hair for my wig. Not the whole wash day thing. I might do an updated one, but no. I put some oil in my hair last night to sleep in and it's just back right now and I'm about to eat breakfast. Let me show y'all. I always have to eat before I do my hair because I always get in a mode and I'm like, I don't eat. So I have to make my breakfast and eat it now. I just have a bagels with bacon and eggs. Let me eat it now and watch Teen Wolf. I'm into that show right now. I'm really enjoying this morning glow and this light right now. I kind of don't want to stop recording. On that note, I think I'm just gonna do the haul now. All right, y'all. So my cap and gown is burgundy and it's kind of like this color a little bit. And so I wanted to get something white so it's not too dark. So I just got this really plain, simple white dress with a little slit from Forever 21. Little slit on the side, it's cute, fitted. I had to get a slip to go under it, so I went to Dillard's. And I'm currently customizing it because it's V-necked and this dress is square necked. So when I put the slip on under, you can see the slip. Here's another thing I didn't mention in my other video. I got a sewing machine. I got a sewing machine for Christmas and I started a small business. Customs by D. I'll put it in the description. You can check it out. This is the slip. I customized it. I cut the, this is where the top was and I cut the straps so I could sew them back on. But I'm currently pinning it down so I can sew it down so it can be square neck like the dress. Anyways, then I also got these sandals. It is so hard for me to find sandals because I'm tall so I have big feet. Just how it is. This sun is hitting. Anyways, I got these sandals from DSW. Super sparkly. Okay, I don't know if you can see all the sparkles. It looks more sparkly off camera. Anyways, got these. I'm so glad I found my size. I went to like Forever 21. They never have my size in shoes. They only go up to like an 8 or 9. If Forever 21, if anyone that works there or anybody's watching this, tell them to broaden their scale because people have bigger feet than that. Anyways, now for the beauty supply store haul. Okay, it's a lot of stuff, so bear with me. I got all the essentials you need. So I got the glue, the wig cap. If y'all watched my other video, you know my wig did not come with a wig cap, so I have to buy my own. I'll just start with this. I put everything in the little dyeing bowl that I got. So I got this Ghost Bond glue, which was $21.99 for how many ounces? If you know me, you know I'm very particular about this money thing. 1.3 ounces, $22 plus tax.
Plus tax, bow.
Anyways. I'm so glad they had smaller versions of these. The developer, I got a 40 developer because I know that takes less time. You only have to wait like 20, 30 minutes, I think. I found, gee whiz. I found the pack of BW2 so I can bleach the knot some more. Then I got these hair scissors so everything can be just more precise and stuff. I got the little brush. I got a wax stick, 24-hour edge tamer, and I got the cup. I'm trying to move a little fast.
Got 300 days.
And then I needed some more leave-in conditioner for my prep for the wig. So this is the leave-in I used. Shea Moisture. I don't use a lot of Shea Moisture because they're expensive, but I do like this, and I can't really find any other, what you call it, like it. They didn't have any black ones, but I got the little elastic band to help melt the glue. That really expensive glue, you know? Yeah, elastic band, it's like a tan color. I didn't get any foundation. They didn't have my tone, my color, so I just got this tinted lace spray. Shout out to Tamari G.I. I don't know her name, but I watch her a lot, and she recommended this, and I got it. I got a hot comb. It was like $20. And I got a paddle brush to keep, hello. And I got a paddle brush to keep the wig nice, you know. I got some more hair growth. I already had this stuff. Girl, if y'all watching this, girl, boy, whoever you are, I'm putting y'all on game if y'all don't know. If you don't know, now you know. And I got some more edge control just because. So that's my little haul. I didn't want to make it too long because I'm having a storage problem right now, so it's really difficult. It's really been stressing me out lately. Anyways. All right, y'all, so we're in the bathroom now, and I'm just about to start washing my hair. And now I have this little bucket that I keep all my stuff in when I wash my hair. So I'm gonna wash my hair, and you guys will see me when I have blow-dried my hair. I'm gonna show y'all how I trim my hair. So I finished just about, and I have this one section left, and I left it to show y'all how I trim my hair because this wig gonna be on for a few weeks and I want my hair healthy. So I just have some leave-in and some oil in here that I had sitting so it won't be dry, and I just take my comb and comb it out a little bit. It's already detangled, but like that. And I use some of this heat protector, this Fantasia heat protecting straightening, for both straightening and blow drying. Oh, it's like an oil type sheen thing. And then I just brush it through. Everything keeps falling today. I'm sick of it. And I like to start with the tension method. So I just hold my hair down. Then after that, I'll go in with a brush. And you know, funny enough, I don't blow dry my hair often, jeez. But for the sake of some hairstyles, I do. So I'll split this apart so it'll be easier to work with. I'll start with a comb. This is the trimming part. Start with a comb, kind of comb through all the kinks, make sure nothing's there. And the way I know I need to trim is when I have all these like frayed, uneven looking stuff at the bottom. And plus my hair has been through it these past few weeks. Now I take a smaller comb and comb the ends. And once I get that, I put my two fingers down like you see most hairstylists do, bring it down. And then where you can see through the hair and like it's really thin, I just kind of snip through there with the hair scissors. I recommend hair scissors, honestly, because I've tried it with regular scissors and it just doesn't hit the same. And you see how it's straight? It took me a little longer today because I was doing a little jam session, as y'all saw. And I really like this spray because you know how sometimes after you blow dry your hair, it feels really dry? My hair doesn't feel dry at all. Like, it feels soft. Like, it's blow dried, yes, but it feels really soft. And I'm done. All right, y'all, so I just finished blow drying my hair. And I cut a little bit too much on this side, but it's fine. I don't really care. Because I wasn't trimming it for evenness. Because my hair is always natural, so it's not going to matter. But I just need to get those ends up and out of here. And yeah, I'm going to do my straight backs now so I can put my wig on tomorrow. I'll just put that in time lapse, honestly. All right, you guys, so I forgot to record. Well, I didn't forget. I wanted to watch Teen Wolf, and I decided I wasn't gonna record me braiding my hair, but I finished braiding my hair, and I just tried the wig
on. It's y'all.
Probably shouldn't have done, woo! Probably shouldn't have done that without the wig cap, but I just wanted to see. I was eager. So basically, I used to do crochet hair on myself, like with the weave and stuff. It was very embarrassing. I can find a picture. I'll put it over here. But I did what I used to do with that, which was after I do the straight backs, I would braid the bottoms of all the braids all the way to one side, and then I'm gonna tuck it. And it actually worked really well when I put the wig on, so that's good. I'm gonna go ahead and end this video right here. The next video is going to be me installing my wig, which is really fun, and I can't wait because I tried it on and it actually doesn't look half bad, but I'm probably gonna have to curl it more or straighten it because it's a little, it's at that weird length where it's like I love that song. Anyway, okay, I'm gonna go ahead and put these back on. I'm washing my silky, so I can't even, oh, I should wear my silky. No, I'm bugging. It's fine. I'm gonna just put this on and I'm gonna go eat because I haven't eaten and it is like been a lot of hours. And I'm gonna catch y'all in the next video.